In the last lecture, we learned how to define the rebar in Revit in reinforced concrete column, reinforced concrete slab, beam, concrete footing, and others. In this lecture, we will learn how to define the reinforcement in concrete pile cap. So I have imported the pile cap in Revit now. From the Revit libraries. You can change the level of the pile cap considering your configuration of the model. But right now our purpose is to place the reinforcement. Here are different parameters predefined for our pile cap, like thickness, width, cutoff level, and other parameters. The structural pile is right now a steel pile, while the pile cap is of concrete. So we are to define the rebar into the pile cap. We have already imported the rebar shapes in the model. We have learned in the previous lectures how to define and import the rebar shapes in Autodesk Revit. So I'll be assuming you have gone through the previous lectures. The previous lectures are given in the Revit playlist in the channel. So rebar 17 seems reasonably okay for our pile cap bottom bar. I am defining the cover for the reinforcement. You can also define the cover by selecting the pile cap, but this is the manual way of defining the cover. I have drawn a detail line as reference line, and now I am driving the reinforcement or stretching the reinforcement to the reference line, and then I will delete the detail line, which is also used here as reference line. Now I'll be selecting the detail line and deleting them using delete button on the keyboard. So I have placed one single bar in the pile cap. You can change the bar diameter from the bar properties. Now select the bar and go to visibility options and turn on the solid visibility in 3D views. So now the reinforcement is visible as extruded form in the 3D view. I'll be cutting a section across the rebar so that I can distribute the reinforcement throughout the footing or the pile cap. Moving from the edge equal to the distance of the cover. Are defining the mesh and the rebar set, number of bars and spacing. You can also make copies of this bar, but a rebar set is better because in reverse set we select one bar and all the bar are selected. And you can edit the spacing and number of bars anytime with ease. Now, I have to define the same reinforcement in the other direction according to the design. For that, I have turned off the visibility of the concrete layer and then I am copying this reinforcement and rotating it at 90 degrees. Now, I have to adjust them as they are overlapping. Also from the edges, or I can reduce one bar. That is how we defined the pile cap reinforcement in Revit. Subscribe to the channel for much more content and visit the channel and click on Revit playlist for complete course. Thank you for watching.